Hey everyone, welcome to this quick and easy tutorial where I will be showing you how to draw the skin using watercolors and also how I draw the jewelries in my ethnic designs. So for creating the skin tone, I will be using colors directly from this Camel Artist Watercolor Cakes palette. You can see that in this palette you have lots of options to choose from, using which you can create your own multiple choice of the skin shades. I have a separate video on how to create skin tones in detail, you can see that too. But for now I will be using this palette, and you can see I have mentioned the colors I'm using. So with this palette also you get a color card. You can refer to your color card and you can see the colors accordingly, and you can find it out that what colors I'm using. So for this illustration I'm using three colors particularly, and you can also see that I'm mixing them very well. And the color you are mixing has to be very diluted with water. We need a very plain wash of the color for our base on the skin. Now using a very thin brush, spread the color very nicely over your face, and don't be too harsh. Use very light hands to spread your color, and remember that the paper is wet, so by moving your brush too much you will just damage your paper. So do take care of your brush strokes. Also, I wanted to tell about this paper. It's not any paper made for watercolors only. It's a normal copy from the brand of Classmate, worth rupees 50 or 60, something like that. So I'm not using any particular paper, for watercolor medium only. So I will let my first layer of color dry very well, and now I will mix this darker color, that is burnt umber, to my earlier color, and I will mix it well, and I will use this color now to do the shading part. If you use watercolor tubes, then you can refer to my another video as well on my channel, which is on how I create multiple skin tones using the watercolor tubes. So yes, you can check that out too. So you can see that how I am building the intensity slowly layer by layer. So if you are new to watercolor and you are trying to blend in the color, as you can see what I am doing in this video as well, a tip I would like to share with you is that always keep a tissue paper with you, And while you are trying to blend your color, you can just dry your brush over the tissue paper, which will absorb the extra water, and that will help you to blend the colors really well. So I am done with my base color, that is using watercolor. Now this is a very good alternative to using alcohol markers that will give you the same look if you can create the right shade accordingly. So instead of using alcohol markers, you can use watercolor as well, giving you the same look. You just need to practice those swatches very well. And here you can see I'm using pencil colors to blend and to give some detailing over the skin tone. So now you can use pencil colors from any brand you want. Just make sure those colors are near to similar to your base color. Otherwise, the contrast between your base color and the pencil strokes will be too high. I don't think so there is a very good alternative to fineliners. I mean, we can use watercolor as well to draw these details, but I'm not very good with watercolor when it comes to drawing this miniature stuff like eyes and the lips. Also, in fashion illustrations, our croquis are very small. It has to be between 1 inch the head we are drawing. So things has to be very detailed, and that's why I like using these fineliners. Also, you can see that I have used 2 tones of skin color pencils to render over this base color. I just wanted to bring a very depth and variation in the skin tone, as this is a bridal wear and I wanted to put a very good emphasis over the skin tone as well. So yes, this is how you can make your own skin shades using pencil colors and watercolors. So I will also do the jewelries very quickly, and all I'm doing is I'm outlining the jewelries very well, and I will use these colorful glitter pens to give the look of those stones, and using this glitter golden pen. And yes, that's very good and quick. I like this technique. I mean, I don't like spending too much time on illustrating just the jewelries. You can see that I have also left some white blank space in the jewelries, which will indicate the golden or the glittery part on my jewelries, reflecting the shine. I am liking how the look of these bangles turned out. I mean, it's giving a very good shine. And do let me know if you like these bangles too. I mean, I'm loving the look. And yes, I think I'm done with this video. I will do the rendering of the garment in my next video. So stay tuned, and I will see you soon. Till then, take care.